Hi, how are you? This is Bruna Roy Crafty Hands. Bruna Roy Crafty Hands. It's been a while. I don't do a video. In actuality, I didn't know what else to make, you know, what project to make. Besides, you know, that I haven't been able to make videos as I've been wanting to, you know, like every week or so, you know, because you have things that get in the way and this and that. So anyway, but today I decided to make a video, and today we're gonna be making greeting cards. So I remember I made one of my last videos, I made a pretty greeting card. I don't know if you seen that video, but if you tune into, again, Bruna Roy Crafty Hands, Bruna Roy Crafty Hands, I'm sure you'll be able to bump into it. But today, we're gonna be making a greeting card. Well, it could be the one that I'm gonna show you that I had made before. It's an invitation card, but we're gonna do something similar with close to the same picture. You know, we're gonna be making on the greeting card, but on the other one we're gonna be making today is gonna be a card, not an invitation card. You know, the one we're gonna be making today, you know, to close. Like a regular greeting card, you know, and you know, you could write whatever you want to, blah blah blah, this and that, you know, but you know how it goes. Anyway, so I'm gonna show you. I not only made the invitation card, but I also made the envelope to match the greeting card. But the thing is that it's not one thing, it's another. The envelope, I kind of made it too small. So when inserting the card, the invitation card, it's too snuggly, you know, and you have to like fight with the card so you could insert it in the envelope. But anyway, okay, so I'm gonna show you. Now, this is the envelope. See? It's a regular envelope that I made. I didn't even buy it, I made it. You turn it around. I kind of put a little design here so you could pan. And for some reason, as you can see, the envelope, like I said, it's not one thing, it's another. The paper that I made the envelope with, for some reason, got kind of wrinkly. As you can see, it got kind of wrinkly. But anyway, let's just make believe that the envelope is nice and, you know, smooth, and there's no wrinkles, and it's perfect. In a perfect world, let's make believe this envelope came out perfect as can be, okay? So anyway, so, and the reason why it came out wrinkly like this, because I had to add two sheets of white paper to make it long enough in order to fold it, fold the paper in the envelope shape. You understand what I'm saying? Because it was too short. So this is why it came out wrinkly. I had to put glue and this and that, and this is why. But nevertheless, let's just put that aside. And but nevertheless, it didn't come out that good. I mean, it didn't come out that bad, let's put it that way. So I'm gonna put it further away from the camera so you will notice the wrinkle, you know, that the sheet is wrinkled. See, now you don't see the wrinkles. It's perfect from afar. Okay, so now, the other issue, like I said, I made the envelope too small. So, not too much when removing the card, you have kind of like a little problem. But when inserting the card, you do have kind of, you know, a problem, you know? It doesn't go in smoothly, but anyway, I'm going to show you the invitation card. This is invitation card. As you can see, it matches. See? It matches the envelope. See? Okay, so this is. I named the little picture, the little doll. I called her in Spanish, Japonesa, which is Japanese. You know, female Japanese, Japonesa. Because I think she looks like a Japanese. Even though she's faceless, you know, but she's supposed to be a Japanese doll, a Japanese girl. See her, you know, her little hat, and over here, you know, decorated, it's like part of her dress or whatever, a bow. Okay, I think it's very pretty. Okay. And this is the invitation, you know, I hope, invitation. Okay, so what I'm going to do, as you can see, I put invitation, and this is four, whoever, a time, whatever, date, whenever, and place, wherever, you know, and then RSVP, okay? Now, this is very nice to send it to someone, if you want to invite someone to a little party or get together, you're planning on making, you know, throwing, okay? As you could see, I'm kind of hiding a little bit and starting the card. But if you're gonna do this, you know, you make sure that the envelope is a little bit bigger. This time, the one we're gonna make today, you know, I'm gonna make sure the envelope is bigger, of course, because I don't want this problem. But anyway, this is gonna be the little greeting card, or postcard, or invitation card we're gonna be making today. But instead, it's gonna be, you know, you're gonna open it and close it. See? Open. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pause the camera, okay? And then I'll be back. Hi, I'm back. Okay, so I'm gonna show you the pattern that I made this card, okay? This is an invitation card, you know? And if you know how to draw a little bit, it's gonna be easier, you know, than if you don't know how to draw. You know, but if you don't know how to draw, you know, you could just go through a nice magazine, you know? They have a lot of nice pictures, you know, and if you see one of something that you like, you know, if you see, like, for example, if you have a magazine that fashion magazine that has a face of a female that you think is pretty and blah blah and all that, you know, you could use that and you could paste it on the, you know, on the card. You know, you could either use construction multicolor paper, you know, and you could use that to make your card. I use this one. This is not construction paper. I use what's called poster board. Yes. Cardboard, you know, and I got it in the 99-cent store, you know, and it's this. This is like construction paper, but this is much thicker, you know, which is good to make the card. See, now you could use both. You could use the poster board, cardboard, and construction paper too, you know. So this, the one I just showed you, is white, you know. So they have multicolored, you see. Okay, now, so what you're gonna do, okay, I'm gonna show you first. Now this, right, this picture, the card, I made from a picture I had made, I drew a little bit, okay? So this is the pattern that I took, that I made the card from, okay? Now first I drew the doll, right? Or whatever you wanna draw. But in my case, I drew, you know, a pretty little doll, faceless doll. As you can see, she don't have no face, but that's what makes it kind of different. And like I said, I had dressed her up with a nice hat and a nice collar, you know. See, so what I did was, okay, this is it, right? Now what I did was that I made a separate, I drew the pieces of pattern in the, which I'm going to be cutting out on a separate paper, as you can see. This is the same thing. See her? This is the same. But as you can see, the pieces are separate. Why? Because I'm going to be, I cut out all of those, these little pieces in, on, the construction paper, or what was it I said? Poster board, cardboard, right? Okay. And this is how it came out. This is how the pieces come out. Okay. Okay, let's see. Now, in this case, okay, what we do first, okay, we cut out the cardboard the size and shape we want our card to be, right? In this case, I cut up the invitation card in a rectangle, of course, right? Okay? So, It's not too big or too small. I thought it was, you know, perfect. Because remember, the picture you're gonna stick on the car, right, has to fit in the frame, right? The cardboard frame. So I'm sure, you know that, right? Okay. So each piece I had cut out separately. See? Now in this case, now I cut out two squares, right? Two cardboard in a square, right? Now in this case I cut out I used the black construction black cardboard or postcard cardboard in black, as you can see. Why? Because I wanted to cut out, the little face. Okay? I cut out the little face from the black cardboard, as you can see. And then the other square cardboard, I used a white cardboard to paste it underneath the black cardboard. In other words, the black cardboard, I wanted to paste it on top of the white cardboard so that the little face will be white. Okay, you understand what I'm saying? Okay, like so. Now this one is gonna be, her face is gonna be black, as you can see. So this is why, because I want the face to be black, I took the, I cut out a white a white square cardboard and a black square cardboard, because I want the black cardboard to put underneath, as you can see. See? To make her little face black. See? Now, see? See that? I cut out the little face. See, the little face looks like a wine glass. See? That's the shape of it. Okay? And then I cut out, see, I cut out the cardboard, this one, I cut out a rectangle cardboard. You know, long enough to fold it in half to make it a greeting card. And then this black cardboard or construction paper, whatever you want to use, I used the black one, okay? Because I want to paste it on the underneath of the white cardboard, right? So that the face could be black, right? Okay. Why? Because I want this one, I want the picture to be of a pharaoh, you know, of a female pharaoh. So, which is gonna be this. Very pretty. This one that we're gonna make today is not gonna be of the Japanese girl, no. This one is gonna be of a female pharaoh. See? Look pretty. Okay? So, I did the same thing as I did with the Japanese greeting card. Okay, after I drew the picture, I drew a second picture on a separate sheet, but with the pieces separate, as you can see, right? Because I'm gonna cut out each piece and then paste them, you know, individually on the cardboard. Okay? You already got the idea, right? And if I'm not explaining myself right, as we go along putting together the making the card, the greeting card, you will understand what I'm talking about. Okay, so I'm gonna pause the camera again and I'll be back. Okay, hi, I'm back. Okay, we're gonna be, like I said, we're gonna be using another picture, okay? And this one, I gave it a name as well. The first one, I named her Japonesa, which is Japanese, because she looks like a Japanese girl, as you can see. Okay? Now, the one we're going to be making now, today, I called her Faraona, which is Pharaoh, you know, female Pharaoh, from Egypt. Okay? Now, so what I, like I explained to you, I cut out, this is the one we're going to be making today. Okay, you see, I'm pretty sure. So, I drew the doll on a sheet of paper to see how she's going to look, what she's going to look like, put it up. And then I, on another piece of paper, I drew the pieces individually, okay? Because I'm going to be cutting them out in a, like I said, construction paper or poster board, cardboard, okay, or whatever you have at hand that's pretty nice and colorful, okay. And then you're going to be cutting out the little pieces. See? See? Now I already cut out the pieces, you know. First, this piece, not this piece, like I said, first cut out the rectangle cardboard, right? That you're going to be folding in half, which is this, right? And then you're going to draw. Okay, so you cut out the little pieces, right? In cardboard, right? You're going to, remember, you're going to take the cardboard that you cut out of the face and you're gonna draw it, right, on the card, on the cardboard, right? And then you're gonna cut out the shape of the little face, okay? And then you're gonna put it aside and this is what you're gonna come out with, you see? See that? Okay, and then you're gonna cut out because, like I said, I want her to be, you know, I want her to have a black face, you know. So I cut out a piece of black cardboard, which is smaller than the actual card is gonna be, right? And then we're gonna put it. We're gonna glue it underneath. You know, on the back, on the inside, but on the inside of the card, but underneath of the, okay, of the front, right, on the back of the front, okay. And then she's gonna come out like that, see. So that's what I'm, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pause the camera and I'm gonna glue this part here, okay, and then I'll be back. Hi, I'm back. Okay, as you can see, I glue, well, no, I was gonna glue the black construction paper you know, behind, and you know, on the back of the front part of the car. But I decided to paste it with double-sided tape, which is a lot more neater, you know, as you can see. See? Okay, like that. Okay, now what we're gonna be doing is putting each of the parts that we cut out, right, from the picture, you know, like for example, this is gonna be the hat, part of the hat. You can see this is what you're gonna be doing. Each of the pieces that I cut out belong on the are part of the a part of her little dress, you know, or her little outfit, let's put it that way. You see? See what I'm doing? In other words, I traced the I don't know how you're gonna do it, but this is how I did it. I traced the each of the pieces on the cardboard or the on the construction paper I wanted to use. So since, you know, I use multicolored construction paper, I had to cut out each, you know, each piece individually and traced it on the cardboard, the color cardboard I wanted to use. You understand what I'm saying? You see? And so on and so forth. Okay? Okay, now you understand, right? Okay. So now, since you already know let's put it this way. Make believe you already cut out each of the pieces you're gonna be using of her little outfit. We're gonna glue them on the card. Okay? So let's start. Now this one, and remember, you know, you have to go by the picture itself when putting together, when gluing together each of the little pieces of her outfit. Because because you don't want to make a mistake, do you? No, I think so. Okay, so this time I'm going to glue each of the little pieces. Come on. Okay. Like that. I put a big blob of glue there, which is not good. Because when you're gonna ruin the little piece. Okay, that's alright. So as you glue, right? You have to, papi, tu puedes pasar, you're not bothering me whatsoever. See, you have to be very careful. Because you don't want to ruin the card. If you put the glue nicely and delicately, you have to clean your hands. Wipe your hands. Because if not, you're gonna make a mess and you're gonna ruin the card. You're gonna be all stained and full of with blobs of glue, you know. And you don't want that, do you? At least I don't think you do. You know? can be sloppy. Okay? Okay. So, see what I'm doing? Now we're gonna. Show you. So pretty, just look at me. See? Pretty? You see? Okay, you see? Okay. So we'll continue. See? Well, you see the hat, I was gonna, I kind of did it a little different. You know, I drew a little checkerboard of black and white, the square. I did it different than I was gonna do it. No, than what I did here, but that's alright. You could use your imagination, you know? It doesn't matter. You know? But anyway, let's continue on, okay? So this is how it's like this. And then like this one. Yes. Okay. I'm gonna do this. So, you know what? I'm going to pause the camera, okay? You already know the steps I'm doing, right? I'll be back. Okay. Okay, now, I'm going to put her little earrings. But she's gonna have earrings. Yeah. Can't go out on a date or on a, what do you call it? Or anywhere without your earrings. Can't go out on a day or you know, on an event or let alone on a date without your earrings. You need to look your best. So she is gonna look her best. Or else she's not going nowhere. She's not walking out that door. Okay. Here's a little dab of glue. You know, when you're gluing little things, you have to put just a little dab of glue, but sometimes, because if you're gonna put a whole lot, the glue's gonna squirt. You know, out the edges, and you're gonna make a mess. And you don't want that. Okay, let's do this, girl. Okay. Okay, wait. She's finished. How pretty she is. Isn't she beautiful? Like I said, her name is Faraona. You know, she's a female pharaoh, as you can see. She's ready to go on a ball or on a date, you know, somewhere special, you see? Okay. All right, so. And in the inside, you know, you can write, you know, you can write whatever you want to here, you know. If it's a birthday card, you could put happy birthday, blah, 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 or whatever, you know, comes to your mind, you know, depending on the occasion, you know, you're gonna send it. before. Okay? Now, like I said, the envelope I already made. Well, not really. I didn't make the envelope. You know? Where is it? This envelope. Oh, come, come. I know I made the envelope. Oh, I know. Okay, you see? This is the envelope. When you make the envelope, make sure, please, if you want your envelope to look nice, right? Make sure that the paper sheet, you know, whichever color it is long enough to fold it as an envelope, okay? Because if it's not long enough, then you're gonna have to add, you know, another piece like I did here. You see the tape, you know, I had to because the sheet of paper wasn't long enough, I had to tape another piece of sheet of paper in order to make the envelope, okay? But this is alright, because I'm going to put something, I'm going to decorate it with something here, okay? Okay, so now this time I made the envelope bigger. Because last time it was too small and I had difficulty inserting the card. So this time it's going to go in easily, see? Voila. See? Okay, I'm not finished yet. Almost. Okay? So I'm gonna finish the envelope and that's it. I'll be back. Okay, hi, I'm back. I think I finished everything. You know, I believe it's finished. You know? Okay. So I finished the envelope. I had to put something to cover the honeycomb, the part where it shows that I had to tape paper to make the envelope bigger, you know. And so I put a construction paper, you know, I cut out a strip of construction paper and I just taped it, you know, with double-sided tape. And that's it, doesn't look that bad. See? This is the front. Okay, so let me just put it here, for example. I think it's very pretty. Okay, it was happy birthday, sis. Okay, but anyway, you can put whatever you want to and whatever. You know. I think it's very pretty, you know. I mean, you know, you don't have to spend lots of money on buying a greeting card, you know, when you could make one of your own. See? Wait a minute. What's this? Okay. Okay. I think it looks very pretty. If you want to make it a little, you know, fancy, you can just cut out. Is it just there? in here. And that's it. Isn't that it? I think it's beautiful. That's me. Okay. Like that. And this one. See how pretty? Okay, let's do this one. Like that, right? And like this. Like this. I'm sorry, I apologize. I'm just being kind of awkward here. Now. See? Okay, so this is our project today. I hope you liked it, you know. I hope you have as much fun as I did making it. Okay? So till next time, this is Bruna Roy Crafty Hands. I see you. Goodbye. Good night.